Hey, we're Veludo and we're at Sound Rehearsal Studios.
Today about what's going on, new EP, which is good news. I'm sure they'll tell us a bit about that. So fellas, firstly, how would you describe your music?
I would say it's a very mixed sound, very modern, with a mixture of a little bit of old school. We're trying to create a positive atmosphere with sounds like bands like The Killers, Coldplay, U2, that kind of melodic rock genre, but maybe with a few different influences. We come from different places in the world, so we've got different influences, and we try and incorporate that to make it a sound that's widely acceptable and listenable.
Yeah.
So if you have to describe it like on Unearthed or something, do you say indie rock, or how do you usually describe it?
We say alternative rock, actually, that's what we say, because there are some different influences there, and I guess, Veludo, the name itself, means velvet in Portuguese, and it's sort of from my heritage, which is Brazil. So I was born in Rio, and it's a Portuguese word for velvet, so I guess that sort of incorporates the texture of the different elements that we put within our sound, and the wide range of influences as well that we sort of pull from to create what is Veludo.
Awesome. So you guys have been playing around, and I know doing a lot of work, but what's been the highlight of your career as a band so far?
Well, Veludo is actually a new entity that evolved from a previous band called Gasoline Inc. And Gasoline Inc. had a much more classic rock sound. We just wanted to, we kind of evolved into this sound. And so we decided to rebrand and call ourselves Veludo. But in terms of the highlight, as Gasoline Inc., we supported INXS, which was like an amazing gig in Broome, in WA. But as Veludo, because we're still kind of just, this is our launch, I guess, this EP is our debut release. The highlight's probably been working with some amazing producers and people for the recording of this EP. We had Jimmy Marutis, who produced, and he's done work with Kimbra and Eskimo Joe's on Aria.
Yeah.
Who else have we had?
Tim Palmer mixed the EP. He's won a few Grammy Awards for Pearl Jam's 10 album. He's worked with U2, Bon Jovi, The Cure, and trillions of other great bands. So we had Travis Dempsey from Living End. Coming out of his retirement to do some drum ticking on the album, and the drums sound absolutely phenomenal. It was great working with him. And then we had
James Reid from the New Zealand band Feelers. He came and lent some guest vocals on one of the tracks and helped write it as well. So it was good to have those people involved in the process. And I think so far that's been our highlight. Is and we want to, what do we do? Music Award.
Australian Independent.
It's a bit of a blur because it's kind of, you know, we're releasing and there's all these things going on, and we did a Music Oz Award in
The Australian Independent Music Awards nominated our very first single, Awaken, for one of the top rock songs, independent rock songs of the year, and it ended up in the top five, so that was pretty intense. Great awards, etc.
Fabulous people. Who's in your support team? So who's making it happen for you?
Well, we've got our manager Jess Ball, and she's been fantastic. She's only sort of come in the last sort of 2 or 3 months and really taken a lot of the load off ourselves and given us a bit more direction and guidance. We've got a publicist in Emily Chung from On The Map PR, and she's doing a fantastic job with the press release and making sure that people are hearing the EP. Unless we've got Frank Barrasso, PA, is plugging it to radio and television, and and then we've just got a great support network of family and friends that are willing to help out, and you know, even Sound Rehearsal Studios, I know, were fantastic towards us when we really needed the time to for pre-production to be in the room, and Anthea did a fantastic deal for us, and we were really, really pleased. So thank you.
So what has been, or what is currently, I mean, given everything's rolling along for you and things are moving along nicely, what do you still find is the biggest hurdle?
I think for the biggest hurdle, I think in general for a lot of Aussie bands is breaking it in Australia, because you've really only got one station in Triple J that breaks artists. And there's a bit of a backlash going on at the moment for those that aren't aware, that are talking about this Triple J sound and a lot of artists sort of changing their sound to fit the mould, which isn't really being true to yourself. And you know, we probably wouldn't consider ourselves a Triple J band. We're a little bit more probably polished, I guess is the word, or you know, not indie enough, but that's the hardest thing, I think. And so we have to go through channels that necessarily don't normally break bands. And usually, as is the case, it's usually when the bands go overseas that Australia starts taking notice. So, you know, we're looking at getting overseas at some point as well, and showcasing our songs to the rest of the world.
Yeah, I would also say the effort to get people to the shows and to see what you do live, because once they see what we do live, they usually come back. But to get them in initially, it's you know, for us being from Perth initially, we don't know that many people in Melbourne apart from a few family and friends. So, you know, getting yourself out in marketing, there are so many bands around, and to really get your name out there can be a challenge. But you know, you gotta work it. That's part of what every band in the world in the history of music has done. You know, you go through the trenches and you do the little gigs, and you build it up from there. And one fan becomes two becomes four, and you know, just got to work it that way. It's all you can do, really.
Yeah.
So for upcoming bands and young bands, particularly, you know, a lot of the young bands that we get rehearsing through here, what advice would you give somebody that's pretty fresh to the industry?
Well, just be prepared to work hard and hone your skill and take criticism, you know, when someone says something, like really take it on board, because usually they're meaning well. And you know, it's a long hurdle, and you've just got to keep going at it. There's nothing we can, I could say, but just keep writing, keep learning. Don't sort of limit yourself to any genre. I think that's a big thing for a songwriter. Like, you know, I'm one of the main songwriters in the band. It's, you can really become closed off to what you're doing as a band, but go out and try and draw some influences from, you know, other genres that you probably wouldn't listen to, and see how they're doing things, and yeah, just keep yourself fresh and in tune with what's going on. That would be my advice, Liz.
Yeah, I would also say try and surround yourself with people that are better than you, people who know more than you, learn from them, draw from their experience. And also as a musician, I believe that yes, you have your main band, but especially when you're starting out, play with as many different people as you can, and just go out there and play every kind of genre you can think of, even if you don't really like it, just do it, because you really learn from those kind of experiences. And working with different people, you got to learn to deal with so many different kind of personalities, and that's sometimes a big challenge. So that's a good learning school.
That's great advice.
Yeah.
So can we bring the cameras in and have a little sneak peek at rehearsal tonight?
If you're very nice about it.
No, fuck off.
I'll try to be nice.
Sorry,
we'll
do that one again.
That's all right. We'll keep going.